But we've got to continue to love that person. And we need God to help us experience that. Because you see, our relationship with God is where we find our identity. It's where we find our strength. And that's something we need to understand. You don't get your strength from another person. You get it from God. And if you look into another person for your strength, that's where you in trouble. Amen? Now, these are just some observations that I believe the gospel leads us to in this parable of relationships and how to settle our differences. I'm wondering this morning, though, is there a relationship in your life that hadn't, or the differences hadn't been settled? As you sit here this morning, can you think of a relationship? Don't be looking at your partner. I mean, can you think of any relationship in your life where some differences haven't been settled? Maybe you need to take that first step and reach out to that person, even if it's not your fault. Now, if it's dangerous to your well-being, stay away. That's a no-brainer, right? Do it by phone, half a continent away. But I don't say this lightly, but there may come a time when you have to end a relationship because it's destroying you. But you see, if you do come to that place in your life, you need to turn to your primary relationship, your relationship with God. It'll give you the strength that you need to be a peacemaker. And it'll give you the strength that you need just to have some peace in your life. And God will honor that request, and God will pave the way for you to settle your differences if you'll learn to say, God, let there be peace on earth. And let there be peace, especially in my relationship, my relationships that are critical and important to me. God, let there be peace on earth. Some of you haven't had any peace in your life because you still hadn't settled a difference in a relationship. It's still haunting you. And I'm here to tell you this morning, God does not want you to go through your life with your head hung down over a broken relationship. You do all you can. The Bible said, as far as it's concerned with me or with you, do all you can. If they don't respond favorably, that's not your problem. You've done your part. You go on then. But as far as it's concerned with you, live at peace with all people. And so this morning, as we sing this song, let this be your declaration. This is how I'm going to settle my differences. I'm going to pray that there be peace on earth and that it begins with me. And I'm going to do what I can do to make a difference. And that's all God asks. If they don't respond favorably, God doesn't hold me against me. I've done all I can do. And that's all God asks for. Let there be peace on earth. And let it begin with me. Let there be peace in my relationships. But let me take the first step. Okay, I wouldn't. It's not my fault. That doesn't make a difference to God. Let there be peace on earth. Let it begin with you. Let's stand and sing.
With each other in birth.
And the people of God said,
amen.
Amen. You may be seated.